Dear students, in today's lecture, we will learn regarding number system in digital electronics. Number system represents the way of interacting with the data that is received by any system in digital electronics. We have a number of digital systems which are as shown, which can be binary number system, octal number system, decimal number system, hexadecimal number system. To get an overview of the topic, we all know that we learn digits like 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, like this. Now, when we learn digits, we have a certain limit to it. For example, if I said I want to learn digits from 0 to 10, then I start counting from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. If I go from 0 to 9, I have 10 digits. So I give it a name as decimal, decimal representing 10. So the number system is decimal number system. So like this, we will see how these number systems differ from each other. Now, to get an overview what a number system is, we'll see in upcoming slides of these different number systems. For example, starting with the basic binary number system. Now, binary means two, so there are two digits. We have to name them, so generally the two digits are 0 and 1. We can also say that the maximum number is 1 less than the maximum base. Now, to know what is base, there is some visualization onto your screen, you can see, represented by capital X and Y. Now, capital X represents the base or radix. We call it as a base number, and Y is the power. The power can be related to the digits in base number. Now, binary means 2, as we have learned also, and it is represented for commonly like with two brackets and with 2 written in subscript. Now, we can see in form of a figure one more time that there is one line which has 2 to the power 0, 2 to the power minus 1, minus 2, up to 2 to the power minus n on the right hand side, and up to 2 to the power capital M on the left hand side. There is one point which is separating these two values, and we call it as an origin. And there is one origin also represented by 2 to the power 0. So we can say that the number system in binary system, the base is 2, so every digit that you see has 2. Now, on the right hand side and the left hand side, there is increasing and decreasing values of positive and negative numbers. For example, if we say into the right hand side, we have 2 to the power minus 1, minus 2, and on the left hand side of 2 to the power 0, we have 2 to the power 0 into the left of 2 to the power minus 1, then 2 to the power 1, 2, and up to 2 to the power m. So we can represent the number system like this. So we can have digits. When we have more than one digits, it can be represented like this. Now, moving on to the next number system, we can have an octal number system. Now, octal number system has 8 digits, so it can be represented by 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Because we can say that the maximum number is 1 less than the maximum base. So, here base is 8 and octal means 8. So, we are representing it as brackets, and within the brackets we use a subscript as 8, similarly as seen in the previous figure. Now, the only change we can see is that instead of 2 we have written 8, because the base of the octal number system is 8, rest all the things are same. So once you are known to the system, what type of system it is, you can clearly differentiate it from the other system. Now we can say that we have decimal number system, which is the most general number system that we use. It consists of 10 digits, as I said earlier also. Those digits can be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Similarly, because the maximum number is 1 less than the maximum base. Now, decimal means 10, and it can be represented as 2 brackets and with a subscript of 10. And in this diagram, we can see that the earlier one, which was representing 2, got replaced by 8 in octal. Now, in decimal number system, it will be represented and replaced by 10. The last commonly used number system is hexadecimal number system. Here, hexa means 16 digits. Now, here there is something to note down is that it consists of two parts. Now, there is one part, but actually inside that one part there are two systems or two digits. First is up to 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, which we see in decimal number system. But after 9, we have letters which are representing a different value. So we can say that A means 10, B means 11, C means 12, D means 13, E means 14, and F means 15. So here these letters represent the digits. We must have to remember that F represents 15, E represents 14, and thereon, like this, D, C, B, A. And also the diagram, the base is represented by 16. Rest all the things are same. So we get to know that there are commonly four types of number systems which are present, but these are only the not the number system which are present. We can do conversion between these two systems. Now, conversion means that one value which is in one number system can be represented in some other system. For example, the binary can be represented in decimal, or we want to represent decimal in hexadecimal, octal to decimal, decimal to octal, hexadecimal to decimal, decimal to binary. So it can be, a conversion can be done, because any number can be from one number system and it can be converted into another number system. Now we can learn more by seeing some examples. Now there are a few digits which are represented. Now in brackets, I have written some digits. Though the answer is written on the right hand side, but we'll get to know how this answer is represented. Now there can be any number of digits which can be used to represent any number system. What we have to see to make that system in category of the four system that we have learned so far, we'll go one by one with examples. For example, in one example we see there are only two digits. We have 0 and 1. So we have to recollect that in what number system 0 and 1 are used. So if we remember and recollect those things, we find that in binary number system we have 0 and 1. It can be any number of digits, it can be any combination, but we have to see the maximum digit that can be represented. Now in similar in octal, we see that the maximum value is 7, and similarly in decimal number system the maximum value is 9, and in hexadecimal the maximum value is F. So similarly we can say that the first is binary, another is octal, third one is decimal, and the fourth one is hexadecimal. So a short way to remember is that binary is 2, as I've said that the maximum number is 1 less than the 2, so 2 minus 1 is 1, so the numbers are 0 and 1. For octal the maximum number is 8, so the digits is 1 minus the maximum number, so 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Similarly for decimal the maximum number is 10, 1 minus the maximum number is 9, so it is represented by 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Similarly for hexadecimal the maximum digit is 16, 1 minus 16 is 15, so 0 to 9, and thereafter 10 by A, 11 by B, 12 by C, 13 by D, 14 by E, and 15 by F. So total number of digits are 16. So here in this we can easily remember with examples how number systems are represented. Now consider one more example of number system conversion. In this example we see that we want to convert a number which is in decimal number system to octal number system. The number in decimal number system is 1375. As we have seen in earlier slides, we can see from this that the maximum number of digits which can be up to 9 in decimal number system, but in this number system it is 7 in this case. And on the right hand side we see an empty number system of which we have to do conversion. Now if we look at the solution, now there is a method with which we can do the conversion. This is called as division method. Now a division method is that we convert the number which is to be converted from decimal to other number system, in as in this case, with the division factor of the number system to be converted. For example, in this example the number to be converted is of number system octal. So the division factor would be 8. If it is hexadecimal, it will be 16. And if it is binary, it will be 2. So let's proceed. If we first divide 1375 with 8, we get not a proper division, but a division which we have 171 and 7 as remainder. So we go up to the exact division that we can have, and the rest number is stored as the remainder. Now we proceed with the next division part. Again we divide 171 with 8 and not a proper division. So again we are left with remainder of 3. Again performing the same step of 21 divided by 8. Again we don't get a perfect division and we get a remainder of 5. Now we start dividing it. Now after this step where we have 2 and 5 as remainder, we see that 2 is less than 8. So we stop the division at this point and we proceed with the number which is left in the last division to the remainder. So if we see the number of remainders we have 7 from the first division, 3 from the second, 5 from the third, and the last remainder that we have is 2. Now as we see, there is an arrow which is pointing from downwards to upwards. We collect the number of digits which is in form of remainders to get the answer. So 1375 gets converted into octal number system into 2537, where 2537 are the remainders that we have collected from the division, and we have placed it in a manner from bottom to top. Here we need to note that the first remainder becomes the least significant digit, which is 7, and the last remainder becomes the most significant digit, which is 2. So in a number system we have least significant digits and the most significant digit, moving from left to right. So in this example we have seen that how we can convert a number system from decimal to octal. It can be other division also when we have other number systems to be converted. Now we have one more example where we want to have a conversion from octal number system to binary number system. Now in this type of conversion, what we do, that we go for pairing of individual digits. In this we have a pairing of 3 for every digit of octal number system. We can just have a guess that 2 to the power 3 is 8. So the conversion is also in the same manner. We want to do conversion from octal into binary number system. So every digit from octal number system, which is 5272, will get converted into binary number system with a pairing of 3. So every 3 digits will represent 1 digit of octal. For example, we can have, for convenience, I have shown 421 as the weight of the 01 binary digits. You can take it as, if we go into the LSB of the conversion 2, we see 010. So if we want to represent 2, only the 2 digit or the middle one should have weight, others should not be having a weight. So they are considered as 0, and the digit to be represented is only symbolized with 1. So we have an answer of 1. Moving left to it, we want to represent 7. Now we want to represent 7, it can be represented by 4 plus 2 plus 1. So all the digits in this code is 1. Similarly, again we want to 2. Similarly, in the same manner as we have done earlier for 2. For 5, it can be 4 plus 1 is 5. So the digits on 4 and 1 are represented by 1. Rest is 0. So in this way, we can convert 5272 into number system. Now there is no particular manner in which has to be arranged. It has to be arranged the way it has been converted. So the conversion will be 101, 010, 111 and 010 into the binary format. So we have successfully converted a number system comprising of digits in octal into binary number system in which the digits are only 0 and 1. Now we have one more example where we want to have a conversion from octal number system to binary number system. Now in this type of conversion, what we do, that we go for pairing of individual digits. In this we have a pairing of 3 for every digit of octal number system, we can just have a guess that 2 to the power 3 is 8. So the conversion is also in the same manner. We want to do conversion from octal into binary number system. So every digit from octal number system, which is 5272, will get converted into binary number system with a pairing of 3. So every 3 digits will represent one digit of octal. For example, we can have, for convenience, I have shown 421 as the weight of the 01 binary digits. You can take it as, if we go into the LSB of the conversion 2, we see 010. So if we want to represent 2, only the 2 digit or the middle one should have weight, others should not be having a weight. So they are considered as 0 and the digit to be represented is only symbolized with 1. So we have an answer of 1. Moving left to it, we want to represent 7. Now we want to represent 7, it can be represented by 4 plus 2 plus 1. So all the digits in this code is 1. Similarly, again we want to 2. Similarly, in the same manner as we have done earlier for 2. For 5, it can be 4 plus 1 is 5. So the digits on 4 and 1 are represented by 1. Rest is 0. So in this way, we can convert 5272 into number system. Now there is no particular manner in which it has to be arranged. It has to be arranged the way it has been converted. So the conversion will be 101, 010, 111 and 010 into the binary format. So we have successfully converted a number system comprising of digits in octal into binary number system in which the digits are only 0 and 1. Now we have one more example. In this example, we want to convert 2b.1fa into base 10. As we can see that we are not being given the number system of 2b.1fa. So we assume and we must write its base first. So as we can see, the maximum number of digits, as we have learned in slide of hexadecimal number system, the maximum letter is F. So in hexadecimal, after 10, the numbers are represented by letters up to 15, that is F. So 2b.1fa has a number system of 16. Now if we want to convert it, we'll convert it with 16 to the power 1 with 2, 16 to the power 0 with b, that is written 11, and thereafter 16 to the power minus 1, minus 2 and minus 3 for 1 f and a, where f and a are represented by f with 15 and a with 10, as we have seen in the slide of hexadecimal number system. So after the dot, the number system tends to move with negative coefficients, and on the left hand side we have positive coefficients. This is also we have seen in number system slides. So if we calculate every part of digits separately and add it, we get a value 43.12353515 to the power base 10. So in this way, we have converted successfully 2b.1fa from hexadecimal into 43.12353516 into decimal. So I want to say that if instead of 16, we have an example of 8, the 16 would be replaced by 8. Similarly, for any other number system, the base will get replaced. So this is one more method of converting a number system from one way into the another number system.